Right, so the question I have is it okay for me to use golf clubs that I've purchased from a garage sale? Absolutely. So when you look at your equipment, there's definitely some improvements that you can make to help you score better, help you hit the ball further and straighter. If you're just picking up a set of clubs from a garage sale because you want to start playing the golf, congratulations to you. That's fantastic. There are a couple of things I would take a look at to make sure that the equipment isn't going to injure you or others. Sometimes golf clubs are left sitting in garages for such a long time that the rubber on the grip starts to get brittle, slippery, or crack. If in the action of hitting a golf shot, that club breaks and flies off and hurts somebody, that would be horrible. So make sure that you're looking specifically at the grip. The good news is that you can take that club to a local golf professional and have them replace that grip for you. The grips are relatively inexpensive and you can get a nice tacky feel, a nice connection to the club, and that will help you play the game way better. So another thing to look at is rust. Typically nowadays we're dealing with all steel or titanium clubs. There are graphite shafts as well. So with the steel we're looking for rust. Now a lot of times you can't see that from the outside because the shaft itself has a chrome to it. A lot of times moisture can get down into the inside of the tube and cause that tube to rust. If that rust starts chipping away or eating away on the inside of that shaft and you strike a shot, your club head can come flying off and hurt somebody. So the easiest way to determine whether or not your golf club has rust in the shaft is while you're in the process of replacing those grips, go ahead and take a look on the inside of that shaft and see if there's any rust developing. With graphite shafts, you want to look at the length of the shaft and see if there's any splintering. Sometimes people's clubs fall over in their garage or at the course and they can get little stress fractures in that graphite. The collision of the golf club and the golf ball causes a force on that shaft that could cause the shaft to snap. So be aware of that and make sure that if that shaft has any damage to it that you don't use it because it might fly off and either hurt yourself or somebody else. So there's a few things to look out for when you're looking at garage sale golf equipment. I always recommend that you take the time to go down and see a professional to help you with your equipment. There are people out there that specialize in this that can really help you understand what length of club, what thickness of grip, the set makeup. But I'm telling you, don't let that be a deterrent. It is better to go seek professional advice, but if you're fired up about the game of golf and you just want to go whack some balls at the driving range and you know that your buddy has a set of clubs for 10 bucks, buy them and go have fun. I would just check out a couple of those safety features just in case, but for the most part, it should be fine. Enjoy.